you want to win an NCAA championship? Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Rutgers Scarlet Knights and the Texas Tech Red Raiders.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Red Raiders should be able to run away with this one, Dick Vitale.
Hey, what are the keys for them doing so? The keys are pretty simple, Brad. Number one, play your game. It's up to the point guard to make certain that they stay in their game and they play at their pace. Secondly, get the ball to your big man on the block early. That'll open up the perimeter game, baby. And finally, don't be passive defensively. Be the initiator and force them to do things they don't want to do offensively.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us. Powers receives the pass. With a jump hook. In and out. Inside. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive scheme.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And the ball goes out of bounds. He's got the post flashing if he wants it. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block and off the mark. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. For the bucket and in and out. He looks for three. He nails the bucket. Gave it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. Burgess handles the pass. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball or let him try to beat us.
Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
The shooting guard takes the feed. Way off target. The Red Raiders seemingly have a solid number of seniors in their lineup. Yeah.
Hey, Brad, you know I love seniors. By the time they're in their fourth year of eligibility, they are solid and reliable basketball players.
The point guard handles the feed. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. Big man spins down in the... Got it! He gets the foul and the bucket.
That's how you do it when you want to win, baby.
The Red Raiders will step to the line for the first time. Sinks it. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
Let's go to the videotape for that one.
I'll tell you what, with a score, this crowd is going to go nuts, Dick. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
They're working around the perimeter.
There's the screen up on top.
Looking for a good shot. Picks off the pass. pack it inside. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip. Going one way, you spin back the other way.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. The shooting guard receives the ball. He gets it to go. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
The shooting guard with the ball.
Hey, kept his dribble. Screen was there, but he couldn't get the shot to drop.
Inside. He's got a nice shot fake. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
From way downtown. Off the rim and no good. At halftime, the Red Raiders lead by three. This one's too close to call here at the end of the first. Dick, do you have a highlight of the half?
Watch some of the great inside work in the first half, Brad. The trick is whether or not they can keep going inside like that in the second half.
Well, partner, let's get back to the game and see how this one plays out. Texas Tech has hit a ton of three-pointers in this first half, Dick.
And if you ask me, Brad, I think that was the difference in the first half.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Tries one from 3-point land.
You guys got the replay ready up there. Here we go.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Had a momentary look from 3-point land. To be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
And he'll kick it back outside. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He shows the sweet touch. Beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip. Going one way, you spin back the other way.
The Red Raiders have a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
Chapman is feeling good.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
He fouled him. Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Way off target. Goes up for two. For two. Buried it. He'll regroup the offense. Now they work it around the perimeter. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. The Red Raiders seem to have that father-son connection going on.
There's a lot of basketball knowledge between them. Their coach coaching styles are obviously pretty similar.
Gave it up. He shoots from downtown. Gets it to go. Vicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
They still don't score.
The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Fakes it. Goes up for two. The Scarlet Knights have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brady's on fire.
Well, partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
Well, there's a turnover situation. I guess most notable, the number of points off turnover.
Well, Mr. Nestler, that's why you want to take care of the basketball. You want to protect it. Turnovers will result in points being scored at the other end. That's one statistic which coaches always monitor.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really good. A great job packing it in. And a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Well, timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. What kind of energy are we looking at after that timeout, Dick?
That's winning energy, baby. The team with the most energy and execution goes home with the big W.
Here's a spin down to the low block.
He posterized him. Take a look right here. He explodes to the basket.
You talk about a great drive. How about the State Farm drive of the game?
I tell you, he was explosive. He was up and away. What a drive to the rack, baby. That was special.
The free throw line. Good.
Timeout. Hey, these kids are driving me crazy, Brad. This game is too close. I'm starting to sweat, baby. Oh, the pressure.
Player's got a much needed breather with that timeout. 2-point game. Absolute mayhem. This place will be in disarray, Dick, if they can get a stop. They'll work it around the arc. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Nobody likes this point of the game, and the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Turnovers, Dick. They just kill you every time.
I'll tell you, Brad, they sure do. You must keep the number to a minimum in order to maximize your number of shot attempts.
And the clock stopped with a foul. I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit. Good teams will get to the line often, but getting there is half the battle. You then must convert your free throws.
Just like in practice.
They really possession game. We've got ourselves a dandy here, folks.
The lead has been trimmed to four. He fires away. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out. I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
See who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, I tell you, won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Red Raiders open the tournament with an impressive first-round victory.
Winning that game was so important. A big first win not only keeps the team's championship hopes alive, but does wonders to calm these kids' nerves entering the second round.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.